Hello, everyone. In this video, we're going to demo shape recognition in PySN, specifically lines, triangles, rectangles, and circles. Before digging into the topic and test files, let's demo this on the fly. So we started with a notebook. PySN made a copy of that notebook, found the hand-drawn shapes, replaced them with perfect shapes, and then uploaded the modified file to the same folder as the source file, adding a mod postfix to the file name. All right, how's that actually work? Let's illustrate with an example in the test files you can find under Demo Shapes, Subfolder. By the way, the README file has all the necessary information. Let's use the Baby in a Stroller notebook. Pardon my artistic talents, but this will illustrate how it works. My drawing is supposed to represent a happy baby excited to go on a stroller ride. I've captioned all these test files so that you don't have to guess what these drawings are about. All right? First, we need to tell PySN which pen strokes to analyze for shape detection. Obviously, we don't want our O letters turning into circles. So we do that by drawing shape we want to be recognized in a specific color. By default, it's dark gray. And remember, these shapes have to be done in one single pen stroke. To switch on the shape recognition feature at the notebook level, we add a special keyword setting, KS Shapes. If you're not familiar with PySN's core features, you can check earlier videos for more info. But basically, PySN looks for that keyword anywhere in the notebook. If it's present, shape detection is activated. The keyword can be placed anywhere, so let's just select the smile, adding it, and launch PySN. It's done, but where's the output? I'll explain that when we're done with this example. Sometimes the placeholder used for the thumbnail will be weird, but don't you worry for now. Let's open the file with the mod postfix, select something, and click to trigger the rendering by the Supernote. Now, for some reason, the baby's smile turned into a full circle. Okay, we could fix that on our source file. But from the kid's perspective and the parent, there are some problems. The stroller now appears to be stuck by the rock, the handlebars are broken, and the stroller's bed is a square. That's probably not comfortable for the baby, and the prospect of a ride doesn't look good. Let's keep this first output by renaming it. Okay, let's fix this in the source file by adding the KS Tilt keyword setting and rerun. So what changed? It's not obvious, but you can see now that adding KS Tilt keeps the rock tilted, and it looks like the stroller will be able to pass that obstacle, but the handlebars are still broken and the baby's still uncomfortable. So let's add KS Trapezoid for PySN to understand that we didn't just draw lousy rectangles, but we meant our quadrilaterals to be trapezoids. Let's rerun. All right, it seems that we fixed it. Okay, what happened in behind the scenes? When PySN sees the KS Shapes keyword, it looks at the notebook's binary data for dark gray pen strokes and tries to detect lines, triangles, rectangles, or circles. Once identified, PySN calculates the parameters for the perfect shape. For instance, two endpoints for a line, corner points for a triangle or rectangle, or center and radius for a circle. A Supernote notebook binary data is organized with multiple references between different blocks of bytes. Swapping shapes of different size would require rebuilding an entire notebook, a potentially lengthier and riskier operation for a large file containing important non-drawing content. To avoid any complication, our philosophy is to have PySN perform a surgical swap, whereby an original pen stroke representing a shape is replaced with a new one having exactly the same number of points. This allows us to keep all addresses unchanged in the binary. We also don't want PySN to keep processing the same shapes on later runs, so after recognition, PySN changes the pen stroke color back to black. Then it swaps in the new data for the shape. That mechanism is also a quick visual indication of the detection success or failure. By default, PySN is going to try to fit a proper rectangle with right angles. But if you really want to have a trapezoid, like it was the case for the stroller example, please simply add the optional keyword KS trapezoid. It's also not easy to have the rectangles totally horizontal, so by default, PySN will correct tilting for detected angles below the default threshold of 25 degrees. Similarly, if you want to keep the shapes tilted, please simply add the keyword setting KS-tilt. One last technical comment and disclaimer related to our desire to proceed with a surgical swap, the ephemeral images. These images are used for displaying thumbnails and exporting to other formats. The Supernote constantly updates such image for each page when the pen stroke's content changes. We know how to recreate each page's ephemeral image with the new shapes. However, including these images would sometimes also require rebuilding the entire binary file, something we want to avoid. This is because the encoded new image may need a larger block of data than the size currently used at a specific location in the binary file. So how does PySN handle that? By fitting only some of the pen stroke's content in a page placeholder image, we expect the thumbnail to still be conveying an acceptable preview while still fitting the space at the same block address. The flip side of that conservative approach is that the placeholder will show both a reduced set of the current content and some ghost information left on the unused storage. This may appear ugly or totally meaningless, like in the baby in a stroller case before refreshing, but it is not a sign of a file corruption, okay? Once you open and trigger the rendering, everything should be fine. To be safe, PySN pushes the result on a different file, and you should always check that the file is okay before deleting your source file. Okay, remember that all you need to know about shapes detection in PySN is summarized in that README file in the Demo Shapes subfolder. All right, folks, that's it for shape recognition in PySN. Don't forget to hit subscribe and the notification bell for future videos. And until next time, happy drawing. Oh,